The late 50s and early 60s was quite a unique time in England, in that there were small town clubs like Wolves, Ipswich, Burnley winning the league.
Yeah.
How was it that clubs like that managed to do that?
Well, in those days, the maximum wage was something like I think when the maximum wage was abolished, it was when the Professional Players Association asked for the maximum wage to be raised from £20 to £40, and it was refused by the authorities because they said that's too much of a jump. Normally, it's you get a rise of £2 every year, but that meant that the maximum wage eventually was fought against and abolished. But before that, towns like Burnley, every club paid the players all the same wage. So it didn't matter where you played. You could be in the biggest city, or you can be in a small town. Really, you could still, the smaller towns got the opportunity to really attract good players. Blackpool, for example, was not a big town, but it attracted your Matthews and your Mortensons. People used to go there. They used to like living in Blackpool, and it didn't matter to Stanley Matthews whether he played in Blackpool or whether he played in a big metropolis like Manchester or London. So. I think that's why the smaller clubs were able to actually attain it, because they were able to attract the best players. Of course, now the wages are important, and of course, obviously the bigger clubs tend to have the big advantage.